Okay, and just to have an idea of what happened here is that Haiti is one of the poorest countries of the world and the poorest in the America. And then when this happened, like the earthquake, this has been destroying for this country, and not only for the country, but for organizations like, you know, press, journalists. And journalists were working in not the best condition in Haiti, because we don't have, you know, materials, we don't have equipments, we don't have the facilities as maybe some journalists may have in, you know, other countries. So it's been going more difficult for journalists to work in that situation, because many radio stations or television stations have been destroyed too during this earthquake in January 12, 2010. And I can tell you that, you know, maybe journalists are now suffering of this situation. They need, you know, materials, equipment to work. They need support to do, you know, to make stories about what happened in Haiti, to tell stories, to tell to the world what happened in Haiti, to go to the, you know, to see people in the neighborhood of Port-au-Prince, capital of Haiti, at Jacmel, or at Léogane, far from Port-au-Prince, about 30 kilometers or 80 kilometers for Jacmel, for example. So how can a journalist work in that situation? Very difficult, I can tell you, because in normal situation, we don't have the facility to work. Like, you know, we don't have a car. Journalists in Haiti don't have a car to, you know, to drive, to go to the hotel and to make report on matters like, you know, humanitarian, health things, environment, which are, you know, subjects very important for Haitian and for Haiti. So I think this is an opportunity for Haitian journalists if they can have, you know, support of international organizations to make them, you know, being closer of the real questions, the real subjects for Haitian lives, like, you know, to leave political or social fights in this country beside the main subject, to have to take time now to make stories about, you know, environment, health, like AIDS, which is a big problem for this country, and then, you know, environment, like what happened in Haiti is, you know, one of the consequences of the environment crisis in this country. So I think we need as journalists in Haiti, we need, you know, more skills, more formation to work. And you have a situation that you know, make journalists very important in Haiti, because we have a population that whatever they have to do, they have to listen to radio. This is 80% of the population, they cannot read newspaper. They cannot, you know, watch TV. They listen to radio to know what happened, what to do, or, you know, even when talking about, you know, sports, like activities like, you know, music, they have only one reference, radio. So if we can reinforce the radio station, reinforce also the journalists, which they are working with the radio station, it would be a good thing for the Haitian press, because now I think in the past, before January 12th, we were in the bad situation, and after January 12th, I think the situation is worse. So we have to work on both sides, for the radio owners and also for the journalists.